Today I want to talk about something that many Christians wonder about. As they walk with Christ, they wonder, what's going on in my life? And I just want to say that we are called to be vessels of honor, vessels of glory. And God has called us to that. And we're in his timeline. We're in the things in his game, the things that he wants to do. And we're performing for him at his will. And I just want you to understand sometimes when talking about the nation of Israel, why they've gone through so much turmoil in their life. Because they've been called to be a holy nation, a peculiar people, amen? A people that love God as a whole nation. But we see that for thousands of years they've had enemies taunting them. Even now, Iran is taunting them. Even now, Russia looks at them, and I know Russia looks at them like a big dog that wants to take them down. Just because God has called them to be his people. And God is shaking that little nation for several thousand years, has been shaking it, especially when they get out of line. God has called them to be a nation that people look at and say, wow, are you blessed of God? The same with us as Christians. God has called us to be a shining light, a beacon of hope for those that are called. But to the world, that they would see God through us. Not only just see God and say, who made the stars? Who made the trees? Who made everything here on earth? Who has made the little children and the old people? It speaks to the world, God does, through everything. And he wants to speak through us, too. And he wants to speak through the nation of Israel, too. And he speaks through the nations. And he speaks through us. We've been called as vessels of honor. Some are called vessels of dishonor, but we've been called vessels of honor. And in Romans chapter 9, verse 17, the scripture says, Pharaoh, even for the same purpose have I raised thee up. He's talking to Pharaoh, and he says, hey, Pharaoh, even for the same reason have I raised you up. I've raised you up to bring you down, that my name might be declared throughout all the earth. That's what it's all about with God. He's God. He wants everybody to know it. And he's using you and me to show the world and show people that he is God. But why does the enemy rage against us? Why is our lives flipped upside down like Israel? For that very purpose, that God wants us to fall in line. A holy nation, a peculiar people, a holy people. Amen? Unto him. That's what we've been called to. You can't get away from it. You can't get away from the call of God. For the call of God and the gifts of God are without repentance. You've been called to one thing. You've been called to one thing. And that is to glorify God. And that is to glorify God. There's some people out there are not called to glorify God. I truly believe that. They've been called to glorify the devil. They've been called like the country of Russia, Iran, evil, wicked countries. Although there is people in those countries that are getting saved, the country itself is an abomination to God. God said that he would put hooks in the jaw of Russia and bring it down on little Israel. Why? Because they haven't accepted the Messiah, Jesus Christ. And God's going to shake that little nation. He's going to get big Russia to come down. He's going to get China to march in the Valley of Armageddon. He's going to get all this thing to happen. Why? Because then the people of Israel, God's people, will cry out, Jesus, save us. Amen. They will be so desperate at that point. We sing the city. They rush on the city and they run on the walls. You ever feel like there's an enemy running on your walls and running over your head on your city? Amen? Amen. Well, that's what God is doing to you. Amen. Crying out to you to cry out to him. Amen. And to follow him, because you've been called to be a vessel of honor and not dishonor. Amen. And until you become a vessel of honor, the enemy is going to run all over you. Amen. Yes. But then, as you walk with Jesus, you'll find out that no weapon formed against me shall prosper. Hallelujah. They'll fall on my right side. They'll fall on my left side. 10,000. But nothing will come nigh me. For I am a city on a hill. Dominated by God. Hallelujah. The glory of God coming down. But God has called us. What if God, willing to show his wrath and to make his power known, endures much long-suffering the vessels of wrath fitted to destruction? God's waiting a long time. You say, God, why don't you come back? He's waiting a long time. He's holding those people off. He wants to bring in the vessels of honor. And sometimes those vessels of dishonor and those things of dishonor and those hard times, the darkness of hell, brings you to the throne of God on your knees. And Jesus says, you've been called. You've been called with gifts. You've been called to be a vessel of glory, to shine me, to shine a light. You, can you imagine a person just giving it up and God shouts out, you are a vessel of honor. You are the light of the world. You are the salt of the earth. You are the preserver of my people. Go into the world. Tell them. Yes. Hallelujah. And that's what you've been called to. You wonder why my life don't work out? You haven't been following God. You got to follow God. You got to fall in the trench where God's at. Got to fall in the groove, man. Amen. He'll give us no choice. He's not going to repent. He's not going to say, oh, you just be a vessel of dishonor and I won't bother you. No. Peter says judgment starts at the house of God. They're the first ones that their lives are turned upside down and inside out. They're the first ones. He says, why do you think it's strange that such a fiery trial has come upon you? Why do you think it's strange? You're in a battle. Expect it. It's a fight. And I will make a way where there is no way. Hallelujah. And then that way God gets the glory. Well, look at your life. Look at what you were going. Look at you now. How about that sickness? God took it away. What? Everybody dies. Well, not me and not today. Amen? God has called us. God has called us. That he might know, make known the riches of his glory on the vessels of mercy which he has ahead or afford prepared unto glory. Now let's run on over to 1 Peter. In 1 Peter, what Paul was trying to say there is that you've been called from the beginning of time. You've been called to be a vessel of honor, and your life is not going to work without God. Amen? It's not supposed to work. There are because of the vessel of honor, and that's what God's called to. Amen? And whatever God will use you, God. Whatever. We don't look at standard. We look at God's standard. And we don't look at what God's maybe necessarily doing in other people's lives. We look at God, what are you going to do in my life? What do you call me to? And we know this, as we draw nigh to God, God draws nigh to us because we're vessels of honor. In 1 Peter 4:17, as I mentioned, the time has come that judgment must begin at the house of God. It must begin at the house of God. And if it first began at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God? What will be their end? Well, they're going to hell. That's their end. Amen? But if we scarcely be saved, if we scarcely be saved. But the end of all things, 4:7, is at hand. Be therefore sober and watch unto prayer. He's talking about vessels of honor. And above all things, have fervent charity or love among yourselves. For charity She'll cover up a multitude of sins. The body of Christ is not perfect. Amen? Let's just love one another. Let's show that love that God showed us. Let's show it patience with one another. Amen? Use hospitality one to another without grudging. Just give it. Just give it. Just give it out. Hospitable. And every man has received the gift. As every man has received the gift. Even so, minister. You've received a gift from God. Minister it. Use it. Amen? Amen. You're the light. You're the salt. Use it. God wants to work through you. And he has levels that he's going to go. And you're always going up. And then he has, even in those levels of going up, I say it again, it's like a graph. It's almost like the Dow Jones. It's up, it's down. But that's how you are. You're flowing with the Lord in your gifts. As good stewards of the manifold grace of God, if any man speak, let him speak as the oracles of God. If any man minister, let him do it as the ability which God giveth, that God in all things may be glorified through Jesus Christ. See, you're a vessel that brings him glory. You're a vessel that brings him glory. That's why nothing else works out in your life but doing that. Yes, God wants you to have a job. Yes, God wants you to make ends meet. But I'll tell you, your call is to glorify God. Amen? Beloved, think it not strange that fiery trials has come to try you. That some strange thing is happening to you. But he says, but rejoice in so much you are partakers of Christ's suffering, that when his glory shall be revealed, ye may be glad with exceeding gladness. Hallelujah. And then I want to read this over in 5. It says, humble yourselves therefore into the mighty hand of God. Just humble it. Just get there, because that's where God wants you. Just do his will. If you said, well, I know what God wants, do it. Today. Don't wait till tomorrow. I put it off to tomorrow. Listen, tomorrows have just seemed to be like next year's. You know, you just keep putting it off. And go, I said I'd do it tomorrow. Well, you're looking at 2-3 years later, 5 years later. Isn't that amazing? Get where you just put it off. I'll do it. And the devil says, put it off. Put it off. Why does he say put it off? Because he knows that you're called to be a vessel of honor. He knows that the glory of God wants it flow through you. And he says, no, just put it off. Just put it off. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. That is what it's all about. That's what you can be assured of. If you fall in the trench with the Lord, if you fall in the groove with God, if you fall in line with the Lord, you are going to be exalted. Why? Because God can trust you and God will shine through you. Amen? Can you imagine? Just what little bit it takes. I was talking to Susie. A few little healings. 30, 40 small little healings. And a couple big, one big miracle. This man that over in Indiana, he's not a pastor, but pastors are calling him that he would pray for him. Baptist pastors. Amen? People that don't really believe that the Spirit of God is here, and they've heard about things going on and people are calling them. And what few little tiny bits of healing that God has flushed through this man, it is shaking Indiana in that area. It really is. It is shaking it. The light is shining through him, bits and pieces right now. What if when the God just pours his glory out through each one of you, what do you think it'll do? It'll give hope to the hopeless. That's why it's so important. Fill your vessels full of oil now. Get ready. Amen? Because God's going to do it. Listen, those words that God has given, he's not lying. And he's not a God that he won't instruct his people. He is a God that will instruct them. Amen. Quit saying, I wonder if that's true. Some of it's got to be true, and it's all good news. What if just half of it's true? You'll turn the world upside down if just half of it's true. Amen?
Right.
Take courage. That's your part. You're a vessel of honor. It only works when you're following the Lord. Your life will only work when you're in prayer on your knees. That's the only way you're alive. When you get up, the things will be okay. Otherwise, it'll dump on you. Again, that's why Israel's having such a tough time. In 1 Corinthians 3:16, it says, "Know ye not that you're the temples of God?" You're the temple of God. "And that the Spirit of God dwells in you. Know ye not?" 1 Corinthians 3:16. Don't you know that you're the temple of God? "And as they'll run on the city and they'll run on the wall of Jerusalem," God says this, "you defile this temple and I'll destroy it." Israel defiled their temple, and in 70 AD, God destroyed it. Paul turns around and says, God is not there, he's in you now. You're the temple of God. You're the temple of God. You're the thing that brings glory to God. You're the vessel of honor. "You defile this temple, and I'll destroy it." Jesus says, "Destroy this temple, and I'll raise it up in 3 days." Because he was a vessel of honor. They couldn't hold him in the grave. Hallelujah. He was a vessel of honor. He was a vessel of glory. You're a vessel of glory. That's why it don't work for you any other way other than being a vessel of glory and a vessel of honor. He says, "My life is turned around in the Lord. I got peace in my home where there was no peace. I got hope where there was no hope." No matter what God would have done for you, without God, his Spirit in you, you're still hopeless. And you saw it as hopeless. No matter what came your way, you're always grumping and growling. You could have got $1 trillion. You know, nothing's ever right. You know, it would have went back to that. Why? Because you don't operate any other way than in through Jesus Christ. Your vessel is designed to work that way. Your life is. And God says, "This defile this temple, go the way of the world, because you're not." He says, "I'll just destroy it. I just won't have it around." You can claim God's my healer, but you defile the temple of God. He said, "I'll destroy it." Why? You're called to be a vessel of honor. First John 15:8, it says, "Herein is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit." Number one, pray the kingdom of God down. You've been called to bear a lot of fruit for God, and you're going to glorify God. And he says, pray the kingdom of God down. Be a good example for the brethren. Amen. It's a program, they can't get away from it. And you're doing your job. You're a vessel of glory. Amen?
Amen.
And then you just tell them, go. Go into the fields. Go take that gift. Let me pray for you. What's your call? That's what you would say. Pray on them. Pray for them. And if you can't, take them to somebody that can. Because when they're called, they're called. And you got to grab them. It's kind of like when the fruit is ripe, you got to pick it. You got to go for it. Your job is to work in signs and wonders. I believe in the last day. Bless you. For people that don't have anything. And you would say, well, the Lord blessed me a few years ago. Well, how did he bless you? I don't know. I guess I heard that I was supposed to invest $100 somewhere and I got $100,000. Well, what brings that kind of investment? You go, it's all over now. It's not important. Here's $100. Here's $1,000. Now go praise God.
Amen.
Doesn't matter. You missed it. But God called it into my life so I could bless you now. That's how it is. It's windows that open, windows that closed. You got to go with the tide. Sometimes you miss it, sometimes you don't, but you're still walking with the Lord. Amen? How come God bless you? I've been walking with God a number of years. He has to. Otherwise, I cannot be a blessing. Amen? Does that encourage you?
Yeah.
I can't be a blessing if he doesn't bless me. And I must bless because that's what I'm called to do. I must. I have to. Jesus said, the works that I do, he shall do also, that you as a vessel of honor. And greater works than this, and who knows what he was doing, raising the dead. I'm raising one dead here and there, but I got a body that's coming that'll raise thousands from the dead. We'll heal tens of thousands. You see this? I got you 12, and Peter, you say, you are the Christ. You are the Son of God. But I tell you, Peter, today that there'll be hundreds of millions saying what you're saying. Because I'm going to the Father and I'm sending the Holy Ghost. Greater works, greater things than what you see going on here. I got 12. But there'll be 12 million here and there doing my works. In fact, Jesus says, I'll let you in on something. Even though you're the foundations, your names are written on the foundations of New Jerusalem. He said, I want to tell you something. I'll have 144,000 that preach just like you, and nothing will touch them. And they won't be afraid of the tribulation. Why? They will know my God reigns. Hallelujah. Amen. My God reigns. Is that not what we should be saying? Oh, I'm getting out of here. I'm not staying around for the tribulation. Let's go through it. Oh. Yeah, let's go through it. Great and mighty is he. Amen. Amen. Great and mighty is he. Let's let God shine. Amen. Amen. Yeah. Vessels of glory, vessels of honor. Let's let God shine in the midst of darkness. Amen. Why would you want to leave? Why would you want to get out? Why would you want to stand in heaven and say, I could be helping them right now. I could be helping them, and they're helpless. They don't know their Bible, and they don't know what to do, and their vessels are not full. Would you turn to Jesus and say, let me go back. Let me go back. Or would you say, stay up there and say, I'm right beside you, Michael, right beside you. I know what you would say. It's all so real to me now. Let me go back. Let me go back. Please. That's a righteous person. Righteous person say, no, let me leave the little children helpless. What kind of parent would leave their child on a curb and walk away? Wouldn't that be kind of what we're doing as Christians, hoping that we just get out of here and let the little ones fend for themselves and let the wickedness come in, drive-by shootings, kill the kid? Wouldn't you want to just be there and sweep that kid up? Say, I'll take the bullet for that little one. Wouldn't you say, I'm an old man now and this one needs to live? Wouldn't you hold life more precious? I believe when you've got the light of God shining through you, preciousness comes in your heart that never was there. When you're a vessel of honor, you don't think like the world. You don't think, let's get out of here. You turn around and say, no. I'm fighting for this one. Amen. Amen? Hallelujah. After we get done here today, I'm going to play this song, and everybody that's watching this, you're just going to miss it. Amen. But what's the name of it? What's the name of it so I can tell them? By Matthew West, it's called Do Something. So you can Google that up, YouTube it, whatever, and watch it. And it's good. You'll enjoy it. In Ephesians 1:15, and how much time we got, Luke? 1 minute. All right, write it down. You're gonna want to look at that. Paul says, after I've heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ and the love to all the saints, cease not to give thanks at you and make mention of you in my prayers, that the God of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom that you might understand who you are. And the revelation of the knowledge of him, that your eyes of your understanding be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling in you. Amen. What is the hope? What are you called to do? Amen. Where does your anointing lie inside of you? Are you to raise the dead? Are you to heal the sick? Or are you just to teach people and say, go out there. If you got it, use it. Amen. Is that what it's supposed to be about? I really believe. What is your call? Amen. What is your call? Hallelujah. Call to Jesus Christ. All right. We're going to play this.